Hey guys, it's HoppingHammy, and this is finally a part two video of setting up a 10-gallon aquarium with my husband. If you haven't seen part one yet, or you need a recap refresher, I'll put a link to that video so you can go catch up and see what part that we're up to now. So this is what our tank looked like at the end of that video, and now we get to see the fun part of picking out our aquatic plants, planting them in the tank, and watching the process of them growing and becoming established. We did a lot of research before going to the store to pick out our plants, and we settled on some beginner plants that are easy to grow and don't need CO2 or any of the additional care requirements. We're also on a strict budget right now, so I picked out one anubias plant, my husband picked out a narrow leaf Java fern, and we both agreed on some Rotala rotundifolia along with a mat of Java moss. Oh yes, and if you remember, the two moss balls are something that I already had from years ago, so thankfully we didn't have to buy those. My husband did an awesome job of planting the Rotala in our tank. Since he used to be a landscaper in past years, I've left most of the plant care and trimming to him because I don't have too much of a green thumb at all, and he does a great job at it. Now, it took quite a while to see the Rotala grow and fill out, especially because I was quite impatient about it. He was a lot more patient than I was, but here are a few pictures of the progress of it growing over time. I wish we would have tracked it a little bit better, but it is pretty cool to look back on these. I definitely want you guys to know that we've battled a ton of problems along the way, and it has been frustrating to fix them, but a good learning experience. Now, at first there was an outbreak of brown algae or diatoms, which apparently is normal in setting up a new tank, so we were able to get rid of that basically by just scrubbing it off all the surfaces, rinsing off our filter, and it ended up dying out, which was nice. Then we had a cyanobacteria or blue-green algae outbreak, which was incredibly ugly and I hated it so much, and it was really difficult to get rid of too. Because we couldn't figure out how to get rid of it, we ended up getting a product called ChemiClean, and thankfully that knocked it out really fast and it has not come back since, so that worked excellent. And then, right after that, we had huge clumps of hair grass algae. I was often spending twice a week trying to keep up with cleaning it out, only to have it come back again. Honestly, you guys, a lot of times this aquarium has felt like more work than owning hamsters did for some reason. But anyway, anything that's new has a learning curve, and it seems overwhelming at first, until you figure out how to care for it and streamline your tasks, and then it's a little better after that. So along the way in this process, we picked up a mystery snail named Cheeto, which I have a welcome video posted on him already, and let me tell you guys, he has been so much fun to have, and he's incredibly goofy. When he was younger and more active, he routinely would crawl up the glass. He'd get to the top and then he'd intentionally let go and ride our filter's water slide all the way down, gently crashing into rocks at the bottom. Then he'd pick himself up, crawl back to the top, and do it all over again. And he would do this like all day long. It was so cute. We've had him for almost 9 months now, and he's gotten huge, but he's slowed down a lot since getting older, and he's not quite as goofy. Our second snail is a nerite snail, which we got a while back to specifically eat algae in our tank, and I never got around to making a welcome video for her, but we named her Roomba because she's like those little vacuum cleaners that move around the house, you know? On the day that we took her home, as soon as we put her in the tank, she made a noticeable difference in nomming algae off of a rock. As you can see here, I kind of documented it. It was really cool. We don't find the nerite snails have quite as much personality as the mystery snails do, but she does a fantastic job at keeping our tank clean, and we love watching her tongue slurp all the algae off the glass. It's really fun having one of each type of snail, and then we don't have to worry about getting an overpopulation of snails in the tank. So this brings me to our next major problem we had to tackle, which was the hairgrass algae. Although nerite snails are good at eating algae off of rocks and glass, they don't really climb up Rotala plants or other delicate types of plants to eat the hairgrass algae. So this was when we decided that we needed to introduce some Neocaridina shrimp to our aquarium. And I have such a crazy story to tell you guys about our experience with that. So I've decided it deserves a whole other video devoted to everything we've had happen with them, because it's been a crazy journey. So I will go ahead and end this here. Thank you so much for watching and supporting my channel through all of life's crazy adventures, and they are crazy, that's for sure. I'll see you guys again soon in my next shrimp adventure video. Bye!